Yes, good morning children. On that day we studied about the longitudes, isn't it? Here I taught you significant lines of longitude. It means what are the important lines of longitude I taught you. In that, about the Greenwich meridian we have seen. Next, today we will see what is the Greenwich meridian, how it is helpful for international standard meridian. It's an international standard meridian to calculate the time. It will be helpful for us. Okay, next, what is it here? International date line, to calculate the date also. Which one we are using? The longitude we are using. How we are using that longitude? It is given here. See there? In the globe, okay, here this line, somewhat zigzag only. Okay, that line, with the help of this longitudinal line, we are calculating the date. Okay, date is there, no, data. That is which line? 180 degree longitude. 180 degree lines of longitude. I told, no, east and west 180. When it comes, means it will be a one line, single line. It will join together and you will get a single line. So this, from this 180 only, we are calculating the date. Okay, so here it is given here. The 180 degree lines of longitude has been fixed as the international date line, drawn on a Pacific Ocean between Alaska and Russia through Bering Strait. So that line, from how it is passing, means it is passing between Alaska and Russia, okay, through Strait Bering. Here you are having Alaska. Okay, here this is North America, and then in this North America 180, where they return there, okay, there you have Alaska, and then nearby that, here you are having Russia, there in Strait Bering, there in that place it is passing, it is passing. Okay, and then if a person across the line, across this line from the west to east, he loses a day. If you move from west to east, means minus one, you will lose a day. On the other hand, when he crosses from the east to west, from east to west, if you are crossing this line, means you gain a day. One day you are gaining. For example, from when you are moving from east to west, it is Friday, means next day what will be? It will be a Saturday for you. Okay, and then based on this, the date is fixed for different countries or regions of the world. So for all over the world, from this line only we are calculating the date. Okay, so 180 keywords, what are the important words, means Alaska, Russia, and then Bering Strait. And then from west to east, when you are moving, you will lose a day. When you are moving from east to west, you will gain a day. Okay, and then 180 degree international date line. Okay, this is about the date line longitude. This diagram, if you keep in your mind, it is good. Okay, and then this diagram for Greenwich meridian, time, this is date. Okay, these are all important things, ma, basics, so you must know all those things. Okay, and then what is earth grid? What is the grid of the earth? The imaginary lines of latitude and longitude form a grid-like pattern on the surface of the earth, known as earth grid or geographic grid. See there? Here you have. See here? Here, latitude and longitude. When you draw latitude and longitude, what you will get means, you will get a box like thing, isn't it? A square, you will get it, no? That is grid. You are having a square, no? That is grid. Okay, earth grid. Okay, to locate a place, it is helpful. It is given here. See here. See here. This is a grid, a box like thing. So many box you are getting, no? This is only earth grid. Earth grid. What is the use of this grid? What it is, when the latitude and longitude moves and it is drawn, you will get a box like thing, a square like thing. It is called a grid. What is the use of this grid? To locate a place exactly on the earth, the latitude and longitudinal extensions are required. So in order to locate a place, find out a place, for example, I don't know where is London, I don't know where is USA, I don't know where is Washington, so where is Brazil, I don't know means backside your atlas, you have latitude and longitudinal extension. If you see that and if you mark it here, means easily, if you refer this, means easily we can locate where is Washington. Okay, we are referring the dictionary, no, in an alphabetical order. Like that, in an alphabetical order, in the atlas backside, you have to refer Washington, W, you have to refer W, Washington W. So W, if you see, means Washington will come. There they will give you latitudinal extension, longitudinal extension. If you go to that latitudinal extension and longitudinal extension, means in your atlas, you will get Washington. So to locate a place, this is helpful. Okay, and then longitude and time. How already I have told you, it is helpful to find out the time, isn't it? As many as 36 lines of longitude are drawn to connect the north and the south poles around the earth, 180 on the east hemisphere, 180 on the western hemisphere. Time is calculated on the basis of lines of longitude. So totally how many longitudes you have? 360. Eastern side 180, eastern hemisphere, western hemisphere 180. Okay, and then here you have so calculated keeping a particular meridian as a standard one. So 180 eastern hemisphere, 180 western hemisphere. For each country, they will keep a particular meridian, particular longitude. So from that only they will calculate the time. Okay, the meridian was selected in multiples of 15 degree or 7/1/2 degree. It is done in such a way that the variation of standard time from the Greenwich is expressed either as 1 hour or half an hour. So each country is keeping their longitude. So based on what they have to keep, means in 15 degree, multiples of 15 degree they have to keep. Then only when we calculate from the Greenwich meridian, from the world time, when we are calculating, it is 1 hour or half an hour, it will come. It will come. So 15 degree multiples we have to keep in our mind. Okay, so in India, how we are calculating the time? Indian standard time. Indian standard time, it is given here. In India, how we are calculating the time? It is given here. This is India, no? Okay, now you see longitudinal extension, that broken red color is there, no? That is broken line, that is a longitude. How much degree? 82 and a half a degree. It is written here. See that? It is written here. 82 and a half a degree. Okay. So from here only we are calculating the time. Calculating the time. Why we kept a separate longitude means our country, okay, see that area is large, isn't it? The latitude is large, longitude is more. That is why we kept an Indian standard time, IST, IST. The longitudinal extension of India is from 68 degrees 7 minutes east to 97 degrees 25 minutes east. Longitudinal extension. See there? 68. Longitudinal extension from here to here, it is 94, 97. Here you see 97. So longitudinal extension is from here to here, longitudinal extension in India. So what will happen? As many as 29 lines of longitude passes through India. So how many longitude passes through India? 29. Okay. And then having 29 standard time is not logical. So 29 longitude means 29 standard time will come. No, it's not correct. Hence 82.5 degrees is line of longitude as observed as a prime meridian to calculate the Indian standard time. So they kept one line, that is what 82.5 degree as a Indian standard time. Is it clear? Indian standard time. Here what they gave, standard time, local time, one paragraph I left here. Longitudinal time and local time I left. I will teach you later. Indian standard time I will teach first. Standard time means what I taught you. Okay. And then standard time I will tell you. And then Indian standard time I taught you now. Okay. This is Indian standard time. How we have to calculate. It is given here. Okay. And then here one topic I left. What is it? See here. Local time. What is local time means? When the sun is overhead on a particular line of longitude, it is 12 noon at all the places located that line of the longitude. This is called local time. Locally, how we are calculating if the if over a particular longitude, if the sun is there, means we will tell it is 12 o'clock, no? Straightly for our head, if it is there, means we will tell it as a 12 o'clock, isn't it? The sun is overhead and a line of longitude only once a day. So the local time differ from every line of longitude. So it will not overhead over the every line, it will overhead once it will head. So we can't keep that as a 12 noon. When the sun is overhead, the Greenwich Meridian at 12 noon, it is the local time of that place. The world time is calculated by the standard line of longitude. Okay, and then it is known as Greenwich Mean Time, GMT. So in news it will come, no, GMT like that. So it is Greenwich Meridian. For example, if the time is 12 noon at Greenwich Meridian, it is 12:04 p.m. at 1 degree east line of longitude and 11:56 a.m. at 1 degree west line of longitude. Okay. So, as one moves towards the east from any meridian, okay, the time increases. And if moves towards the west from any meridian, time decreases. This is important. Greenwich Meridian, 0 degree, you know that. So, when you move towards the east of the Greenwich Meridian, you will gain the time. Okay. When you move towards the west of the meridian, the time will minus like the date. So local time means if a sun is overhead over a particular longitude means 12, but we can't calculate, so we are using the Greenwich mean time. And then from the Greenwich mean time, how we have to calculate the time, it is given here. Okay. East means gain a day, west means loss, losing the time, not a day, losing the time. Okay. And then here one topic, standard time. What is standard time? Local time is calculated when the sun is overhead at noon. Many lines of longitude may passes through a country. Countries may not be observed the common time. The standard time of a country as part of it is calculated keeping a particular meridian as a standard one. So local time we can't keep because 29 longitude is passes through India. So we can't keep local time for India. Okay, so we have to select a meridian. Okay, so the meridian are selected in multiples of 15 or 7.5 degree. Like this, in this manner, we have to select the meridian and then with the help of the Greenwich meridian, we have to keep the time. We have to keep the time. Is it clear? Okay, so here, what is an important thing means, how we have to keep 15, multiples of 15 or 7.5. Okay, and then India, it is passes through 82 and a half a degree. IST means Indian Standard Time. If you know, it is enough. 82 and a half a degree, if you know, it is enough. Okay, and then this one you must know. The local time means the sun is overhead, but it is not possible. And then Greenwich Mean Time means 0 degree. If you move towards east means time will increase. If you move towards west means time will decrease. Okay. If you read this particular paragraph, you can understand what the thing want for you. That is enough. Okay. And then this is a diagram in order to represent the map, in order to represent the time, it is given here. Okay, see the world time zone. Okay, world time zone, in that prime meridian is given here, 0 degree longitude. Okay, and then next one is, what is the next one here you have? Okay, here. The world has 24 time zones. The map they have given, no? So world time zones, it is the map. Okay. So in this, how many time zones you have in the world means 24 time zones we have in the world. Some countries have a great longitudinal extent. So they have more than one standard time. So in India we have one standard time, no? Some of the country, if it is large means more than one standard time will be there. For example, Russia has seven time zones they are having. With the help of that seven longitude time zones, they will calculate the time. Because their country is so large, that is longitudinal extension is more. So what will happen? 24 time zones for a world, it will come. It will come. Okay. And then next one. We saw about the lines of longitude and latitude and longitude drawn on a globe. Besides these, physical landforms, seas and oceans, countries, etc. are also found on a globe. On a globe. So this is wrap up. Okay. So our lesson is globe, isn't it? So in a conclusion, what it is given? We read only about the latitude, longitude, isn't it? But in a globe, what are the other things you have means? Landforms is there, seas is there, oceans and countries also you can see in a globe. You can see in a globe, not only latitude and longitude. Okay, that is what they gave about the globe. Okay, our lesson is globe. That is why they gave about the globe. Is it clear? And then wrap up. This is, what is it? This is the summary of the lesson, summary of the whole lesson. Okay, so what are the things you can see in the globe apart from latitude and longitude? And then 24 time zones are there, then Russia 7 time zones are there, and then time zones, the map they gave. Okay, and then Indian standard time, Indian standard time, IST, 22 and a half a degree. And then here, local time, 12 noon, and Greenwich mean time, gaining and losing the time. And then here, earth grid means what? Earth grid means what? How we have to calculate the earth grid? okay, I'm sorry, cannot calculating, how we have to locate a place, and longitude and time, about that it is given here. Okay, one good box they gave here, just for reference you keep this. Okay, see that the earth takes 1 day to rotate on its axis. You know that on its own axis, if it want to rotate, means how many days it will take? 1 day. 1 day is equal to how many hours? 24 hours. You know that, isn't it? 24 hours is equal to 1 day. Okay, 1 hour is equal to how many minutes? 60 minutes. So 24 hours is equal to 1440 minutes. The angle of the earth is 360. How many longitudes? 360. So 360 degree is equal to 360 longitude. So 360 degree is equal to 1440 minutes. So 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. That you must know. Okay. And then 4 minutes is equal to 1 rotation. In 4 minutes you will get 1 rotate. 4 minutes you will get 1 degree rotation. And then this is, so in an hour, 60 minutes, the earth rotates 15 degree. So for 1 hour, how much it will rotate, means for 15 degree it will rotate. Okay, just you recall this. Okay, just you recall and you understand that. Okay, degree, 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. This is degree. Okay, 1, like 0 is given, no, that is degree. Okay, so in geography, this is a basic concept. You just sit and see for 1 or 2 times, you can understand. Nothing is there. 1 day, 24 hours, 1 hour, 60 minutes. So 24 into 60 they put. And then we have 360 longitudes. And then 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. So for 1 hour, it will rotate for 15 degree. It will rotate for 15 degree. That's all. Okay. So this lesson is over. I mark and send the PDF for this lesson. I send the full lesson. Isn't it PDF? I send already for you. With the help of the PDF, you finish learning. That is the homework for you children. Thank you, ma'am.